Let's talk about Sig Fig rules. Of course, Sig Fig stands for significant figures. And I think it's fair to say that Sig Figs are one of the most hated concepts by chemistry students. Yet they're one of the most important. They're in almost every single problem you end up doing. And so it's really important to hammer in those rules. Just as an additional note, sometimes you'll see them written as SFS. If you ever see that on a piece of paper or exam graded with points off, that stands for Sig Figs. Okay, so today I'm going to go over the 5 rules that kind of guide all the Sig Figs, and this is all you need to know to assign how many Sig Figs are in any number. So starting with rule number 1, any non-zero numbers are Sig Figs. So this takes care of most of your numbers, right? 1 through 9. Anytime you see anything that's not a 0, that is a Sig Fig. So now let's do a couple of examples just to drill that. So 17, our two digits, are 1 and 7. Neither of those are zeros, which means both of them are Sig Figs. And so our total number of Sig Figs in this number is 2. And that goes for 5,631.54. Doesn't matter if it's a decimal point or a big number, as long as it's not a zero, that's always going to be a Sig Fig. So in this case, our 5, our 6, our 3, our 1, our second 5, and our 4 are all Sig Figs. So the total number of Sig Figs in this number is 6. All right. And so since we already took care of all the non-zero numbers with rule number 1, rules 2, 3, 4a, and 4b are just talking about zeros. So when we talk about Sig Fig rules and how to assign Sig Figs, we're really talking about zeros. Those are the hard ones. So rule 2, any zeros in between two non-zeros are Sig Figs. Okay, so let's go over to an example. We have the number 101. Right away, we know that both ones are definitely going to be Sig Figs just because they're not zeros. So we can check those off. And then now our zero is in between two non-zeros. It's right in between those two ones, so it is going to count as a Sig Fig. So this means that our number 101 has a total of 3 Sig Figs. And that goes for the next example as well, 2,009,000. And so we know that 2 and 9 are both going to be Sig Figs because they're not zeros. And you can take a look at all of these zeros, all 5 of them are going to be Sig Figs because eventually you might have to go out a couple of zeros for the one in the middle, but eventually you would get to some non-zero for every single one of those zeros on both ends. So it doesn't matter, even though the zero in the middle still has a bunch of zeros around it, eventually it is in between two non-zeros, so it's always going to be a Sig Fig. And this is also called like a middle zero. Those are always going to be Sig Figs. So we can check everything in this number, and the total number of Sig Figs that this number has is 7. Alright, so now moving to rule number 3, any zeros before non-zeros are not Sig Figs. So this is, we're basically just going through all the different types of zeros we can have. So we already dealt with them in the middle, and now we're talking about zeros that happen before non-zeros. Non-zeros are just numbers, 1 through 9. So for this example, let's look at 0.5. We can see there's that 0 there on the 5. The 5 we know is a Sig Fig, so it's not a 0, so we can check that off. And now we look at where that 0 is, and it's not in the middle, so it doesn't count. It's before, so it definitely doesn't count. So it doesn't matter what place you're in, it's not going to count if you're before the numbers. And so 0.5 is just going to have 1 Sig Fig, and then if we look down at our next example, it's 0.0001305. So in this case, we can immediately check off all of our non-zeros. We know 1, 3, and 5 are all going to be Sig Figs. And now that 10 in between the 3 and the 5, that's rule 2. That's a middle zero, so that counts. And now rule 3, that's talking about every single zero that we see before you see that first non-zero 1. So these 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros are all not Sig Figs because they're before. And so the total number of Sig Figs this number has is 4. It's the last 4 digits you see. All right. So now let's go to rule 4a. This says that any zeros after non-zeros in a number without a decimal point are not sig figs. And so rule 4a and rule 4b are just talking about zeros that happen after the numbers. Because in 2, we took care of the middle. In 3, we took care of the ones that come before. 4a and 4b are just the zeros that are after all of your non-zeros. So 4a is just talking about numbers without a decimal point. Whether or not you have a decimal point really matters for sig figs. So if we look at 500, we know that 5 is going to be a sig fig because it's not a zero. And then both of our zeros are after that 5, so they're called trailing zeros sometimes. And because there's no decimal point in that entire number, they're both not sig figs. They don't count for anything. So the entire number of sig figs in the number 500 as written is only 1. And that goes for the same thing as 10,000. So there is no decimal point in that number, and every single zero you see comes after the non-zeros. So that means that 1, of course, is a sig fig, and then the 4 zeros after it are not. So again, this for this number, the total number of sig figs for the entire number is just 1. So now let's look at our last rule, rule 4b, which says any zeros after non-zeros in a number with a decimal point are sig figs. And so 4a and 4b, we're just talking about trailing zeros that happen after all the numbers, and we're just talking about whether or not there's a decimal point. So the rule is that if there is a decimal point in any place in the entire number, everything that's a trailing zero, every zero after the non-zeros, is a sig fig. So now let's take a look at 500, the same number that we saw a couple of examples ago, but it's written differently. Now this time it has a decimal point and an extra zero. So of course 5 is going to be a sig fig because it's a non-zero. And now this time every single zero counts as a sig fig because there is that decimal point there. And so this 500 has a total of 4 sig figs overall. And so now let's do a couple of combined problems. So our second to last, we have 0.0310. So none of our leading zeros ever count. That's rule number 3. And then we have 3 and 1. Those are non-zero numbers. They're always going to count. And now we have one last zero. It's a trailing zero. It's after all the non-zeros. And there is a decimal point somewhere in the number, which means that it is going to count as a sig fig. So this number has 3 sig figs. And now let's do a really long example that has a ton of different types of zeros and other numbers. So first, I always go around and I just check the non-zeros because those are the easiest rule to follow. It's not a zero, it is a sig fig. So I check off 1, 3, 9, 5 and my other 3. And now I go through and I check all my middle zeros, the kind of zeros that are like this meat of the sandwich in the number. So I've got 3 middle zeros I can check off. And so now I'm just looking at the before zeros and the after zeros. So my trailing zero, it's at the very end of this number, there's just 1. And even though it's a bunch of decimal points forward, that decimal point is in the number, so this trailing zero does count as a sig fig. And then all I have left over are my 2 leading zeros, which happen before you see any non-zeros, which means there's no way they're sig figs. So both of these guys are not sig figs. And so in total, this number has 9 sig figs, so it's first 2 don't count. All right, well, thanks so much for watching. That's all I have for you today. And good luck with sig figs. I know everybody hates them, but they are really important and they are useful. Bye-bye.